He leased his home to an agency that gives the intellectually disabled a place to live. Now he's been left with a big mess and a mission to hold some people accountable. It is a News 8 exclusive. And good evening, everybody. That homeowner contacted News 8 through Reported saying the disabled tenants were living in unsafe conditions because of the supervisors.
Agency running the home says that man is flat out lying, and their lawyers are well aware of that. News 8's Erin Logan has been digging for answers. She joins us now live. Erin.
And Keith, the homeowner has filed police reports because of what he feels is reckless endangerment. The home was being supervised and run by Key Human Services, which the Department of Developmental Services oversees. Those agencies deny all allegations against them.
Yes, I would like to see people arrested that were treating these people so badly and inappropriately.
From powerful statements to pictures, David Jacobs says he's proving a point that what went on in his Guilford home disgusts him. He leased his home to three people with intellectual disabilities back in 2006. It was being run by Key Human Services, which is overseen by the Department of Developmental Services.
These caretakers just did a horrible job of taking care of the clients.
They moved out of Jacob's home in June. He says the hole in the wall, the broken window, and the bathroom floor are just some of the damages left. The man hired to fix this mess in the kitchen reacted to what he's seeing.
Solid year plus of neglect, water damage, mold and mildew throughout, rot.
Jacob says Key tried to cover up the damages. Key says he refused to make repairs.
The nurse admitted that in addition to reckless endangerment of leaving that window open, that they allowed the resident to bang his head against this plaster wall, which is much heavier than sheetrock.
Key and DDS didn't want to go on camera, but said in a statement that, quote, Mr. Jacobs has undertaken an unrelenting and reckless campaign of making unfounded and defamatory accusations against Key. Key will take any and all actions necessary to protect the individuals, itself, and its employees against Mr. Jacobs. In early June, police investigated and determined that assistance from DDS and the Guilford Health Department wasn't needed. Jacobs finds that frustrating.
I've got the back of these disabled people that were renting from me.
Now, Jacobs says he won't give up until he gets answers and feels that these disabled people are getting the care they deserve. To read the full statement from Key Human Services, just go to our website, WTNH.com.